We're going to talk about the male neurotoxins, how we treat hyperanimation in men. So many times as people get older, the brow comes down and these lines form because you lose volume and there's four muscles bring the brow down and only one to bring the brow up, right? So the frontalis bring the brow up, and then the corrugator, the depressor, the procerus and bicuspid cycline muscle, they all bring the brow down. And it's a little bit different than an aged person, because an aged person, the brow drops, they lose volume, and then they're compensating for the brow going down. So every time they look in the mirror, they raise, and then these things are coming in as horizontal static lines. These lines are made by the procerus muscle that gives you the horizontal lines above the nose here, and then the depressor. Then there's the corrugator muscles that runs from here, the head of the corrugator, all the way to the tail. So these three muscles, the procerus, the depressor, and the corrugator, they bring the medial and the head of the brow down. The orbicular cycline muscle, look all the way around the eye, those are the lateral depressor of the brow. Now, other places that men tend to need Botox is the masseter here. Sometimes we Botox in men because they have grinding, or sometimes when men have really, really strong jaw lines, it makes it almost like a cherubic type of face. You know, so aesthetically, they'd be better if they're thinner out here. So you can Botox those. When you do Botox this, they can create a little bit of laxity down by the jaw area. So I don't think that'd be a good thing in you. So we're not gonna do that, okay? So we're here, okay? So we're just about to do this Botox. So very important thing we wanna do is we mark the patient. I mark with this little pen because I don't think people use crayon, but this is just giving me a little tiny dot and being very precise. And this pen are able to be wiped off with a little alcohol very easily. I'm marking the head of the corrugator and this depressor muscle here. So you see, there's several injection points and each injection point is gonna be one unit. So there's a lot of little injection points because you want to get this into the entire length of the muscle. The way people do it, if they're very concentrated, then they inject only one place. You're gonna neutralize one area, and the other parts of the muscle is not neutralized, and they can act kind of funny. They can sort of compensate kind of with funny motion. So we want to make sure that we get all the entire length of the muscle. Lateral depressor of the brow, which is the orbicular cycline muscle. So we see the action of the muscle. What I like to do is raise the brow a little bit. So I start under the brow. I know a lot of people get nervous about injecting so close to the eyes. But I'll show you how we do this, try to mitigate the problem with dropping the eyelid, get it into the levator muscle. So when we do surgery, we see this is a very thin muscle. It is very flat and wide. So I'm just kind of outlining the area. You see these little veins here we want to avoid. So now for the frontalis muscle, this is probably the trickiest part of Botox, in my opinion, because you know, you really have to be symmetrical so the result is symmetrical, because you don't see it working right away. So now he has very, very active frontalis. I'm gonna come pretty low on him because his wrinkles are not compensatory. They are just congenital and hyperactive, right? So I'm not really worried about dropping his brow too much. So here you see, these are all symmetrically placed, one side the other. Now, if he was older, obviously we can't Botox so low then, because then we'll take away all the function. If that's the case, then we stay up in the upper one third or half of the forehead. So the other thing is that, you know, in men, naturally, their muscles are just much, much thicker, and their skin's thicker, and so you're gonna take a lot more units of neurotoxins. Right now, usually on female, I'll use, you know, all these dots, they'll be about 20 units of in the glabellar area, 20 units in the orbicularis oculi muscle, and 20 units in the frontalis. But here, in men, it's gonna be more. So probably maybe 30 units, 30 units, and 30 units. Okay, so now we're ready to inject this, right? So you notice that I kind of palm the syringe. So
I use my hand, I always retract up
because we don't want to place it too low.
Then we inject and we put 0.05 cc's.
So 0.05 1 unit. So I'm placing 1 unit in each little dot. And also I'm not going right over the ink mark because I don't want to tattoo him, but this ink just go right next to it.
I appreciate that.
So we're just getting the depressor here and then the head of the corrugator right here. Okay, so you see I'm injecting a little bit into the muscle, injecting, and I'm pulling back a little bit so there's no leakage. So here, injecting, 0.005, coming out, injection, and then I'm pulling back a little bit on the syringe. So he's being like very patient, you're not even flinching. Not like most guys, they just faint. Good, so the glabellar is pretty much done. And then we're gonna come over here. We're gonna inject the orbicularis oculi muscle. So this is what people get really nervous about because I'm underneath the brow. When we do this, we wanna retract up like this. And so we're away from the eye. And we're gonna give it, again, 1 unit, which is the way we dilute it, is 0.05 cc's. Good, see, that's done. So now we've done the corrugators, the depressor, the procerus, and a little bit of the orbicularis oculus. Now we're gonna get the rest of the orbicularis, the lower orbicularis here and here. Now I do this in two ways. One way is sort of different needle points. The other way is kind of a fanning kind of technique that I do. And it really depends on how wide the muscle is. So we have to be careful of these temporal veins here. So we're gonna try to make sure that we don't wanna get into one of these. You do not want the Botox in the zygomatic major or minor muscle. If you get too low down to the body of the zygoma, then you will also cause inability to smile evenly. Here on this side, I'm gonna use a different technique. So this is a fanning technique. I'm gonna use a 30 gauge 1 inch needle now so I can fan. So you see the little veins here. I wanna avoid these little veins. I'm gonna come back in the cheek skin here so I can avoid some bruising because the skin gets thin over here. So I'm gonna enter right here. And then I'm gonna go underneath that vein. This is where the tip of my needle is. So to reach over here, then I'm gonna retrograde, I'm gonna inject like here, and then stand over here, slowly entry, so I don't cause any bruising, so I don't get into any vessels. It's a fan-like muscle, so it makes sense to me to give it in a fanning pattern so that it gets into as much surface area of the muscle as possible. Okay, so now is a moment that we've all been waiting for, or this is the Botoxing of the frontalis muscle. So again, the marking should be very symmetrical. And again, these are a little bit lower than I would normally for an aged person because he doesn't compensate, and these are just hyperactivity. So these are just little tiny wheels that I'm putting in here. I'm getting down in the muscle. You can sort of hear the crunching, right?
Oh yeah, I can feel the crunch.
Yeah, the crunch. Sometimes people, they place it very superficial in the skin, and then take some time for the Botox to diffuse into the muscle from above. I like to place it into the muscle itself, so I'm going to the bone, really. It probably hurts a little bit more.
It's not that bad.
But it works a lot faster, and I think it lasts longer as well.
How many days has it been since we Botoxed you?
It's been 6 days.
6 days?
Yeah.
Okay, so try to raise your eyebrow.
Yeah, I can't. I can't do it. I've been trying. And I swear, by day two, I couldn't do this.
Day two?
Yeah.
You know, this is what people say to me a lot. It's because we inject right into the muscle, so it hurts a little bit more, but it works a lot faster.
It didn't hurt at all.
Okay.
It really didn't.
Well, you're a super human. and then also because we do microdosing, we get the whole muscle, so it affects the muscle a lot better. I'm trying to squint and squeeze those corrugators. Okay, relax. Again. Okay, good. All right. Again. Okay. This time we use the individual injection technique. Okay. We use the fanning technique on this side. Right? So the cruelties are much better.
Mm-hmm.
But
and not a bruise, not a single one.
Damn, did this really happen? Okay. All right, that's great. Thank you.